like lately things have happened in your life where you were forced to show a lot of strength and now you want some sort of peace and comfort. Okay, what happened in Aquarius Six of Wands? Yeah, people, and see, Star card, your card at the bottom. People really don't know what's up in your life these days, Aquarius. I mean, kudos to you that you have been maintaining your stand in your life and you have been handling things really, really well. I see a lot of changes have happened in your life. And these were really fast-moving changes with the Six of Wands and the Magician card. I see things have very quickly changed in your life. Some in your favor, some against you. You did not really get much time to contemplate. And you also did not have a lot of choice. So some of you, it's like you were just going with the flow. You were not trying to obstruct. However, even when the situation got a little tough, you were really showing a lot of strength, okay? So when people look at you from the outside, they are like, yeah, Aquarius is doing well, what's up? But internally, I see that you have been healing, okay? And things were really tough for you and you really maintained that balance in your life and you were really being very, very calm in the situation. Okay, what is coming next for Aquarius? Six of Cups, there could be... Do you have somebody on your mind? Ten of Cups, you really love this person, like... A lot of feelings that you have for someone. Some of you, it's a water sign, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, and you're trying to manifest the communication as well here. And I see that's coming in. So this reading straight up shows a reconciliation energy. I see that you have been waiting for this communication, or you have been waiting for something in your life. For some of you, it might not be communication. It's like something which brings you a sense of nostalgia. Like you really, really want something to happen in your life in a certain way. And with the Ten of Cups and the Six of Cups, this looks like a very big wish fulfillment, which is going to make you really, really happy and sufficient, and you're going to basically feel complete. You're like, yeah, I have this in my life and my life is complete now, you know? So yeah, see, Three of Wands, you have been going after this for a very long time now. Some of you, legit 6 months or last 3 months of your life, you really were going after this goal of your life. It could be communication, could be a reconciliation, could be a career. Or, you know, like from an Ace of Cups, I just realized that you were manifesting this peace of mind and this emotional stability, and you're achieving that. So the emotional stability that you were trying to manifest here, you are going to get in. And it's going to bring in a lot of peace and a lot of the sense of nostalgia. Like you will feel very much at home with yourself, you know. This is good. This is a good reading, Aquarius. So far, so good. Okay. What happened in the past in this love connection? Two of Wands and the Five of Cups. Maybe somebody chose someone else over you. I don't know. There was like somebody kind of disappointed you. You were really hoping for an expansion with this person. You really had hopes of settling with them or communication or commitment. I don't know. But I see that either a lot of people got involved, or you both were just constantly fighting and nagging, and that led to a lot of disappointment. I see some of you, you spoke to this person, there was communication, and the communication actually turned dirty or violent. For most of you, I think it just turned really dirty. Like a lot of people got involved, a lot of opinions came in. So basically whatever you wanted out of the connection, it did not go as per the plan, you know? So yeah, something basically got a little messy in the past. Let's see for your future. And then after that, I think you have now been in your own energy, because I saw the Hermit card. So in your, like after this ugly fight, you basically distanced yourself from this person and you started focusing on your own growth, self-growth, you know. In the future, I see Judgment card, which shows that some sort of decision that is pending is going to be made. And this is going to bring in some changes in your life, okay? Things are going to turn. What else? Queen of Pentacles. I see stability in your life, especially money. You know, if you have been having issues with money, I see that your money is going to improve. And some of you, you know, you're also going to go after things that light up your soul. Okay, you're going after things that bring in a lot of stability and happiness in your life. You're really prioritizing your stability and happiness these days. And you're also trying to be by your own self. Queen of Pentacles in the Sun card shows that you do not rely on somebody to bring happiness in your life. and you're just trying to be by yourself and make basically do things that make you happy. You know, this heartbreak still bothers you, but still you're just very much focused on your stability. So it's like you're trying to distract yourself with things that make you happy so that you do not feel sad and you're doing well. Like you're doing a good job at it, basically. What else? What else? Seven of Swords. Yeah. Somebody basically... who the fuck were you dealing with? Somebody basically has really cheated you, or they were just acting very sneaky. Somebody was not telling you what it is exactly. This person was hiding facts from you. They kind of played dirty, you know, like there are two type of breakups. One breakup is where two people feel that they are no longer compatible or they have different ways to go and then they just part ways. And the other breakup is where the person start playing dirty. So you were dealing with someone who kind of played you dirty, okay? And it has been very disappointing for you because you're like, I wanted a be all end all with you and what the fuck are you doing, you know? Some of you are also saving money these days, or you should save money these days. Just take care of your spending habits, because I'm seeing this pentacles a lot. Though I'm seeing that your money looks good, but if you are spending ruthlessly, then please take care, okay? And this person, that whoever you were dealing with, very toxic person. Cheater, narcissist, low level drama queen. Okay, what was the obstacle here? Death card. Somebody was just not revealing themselves. Some of you, there was a money involvement here, so maybe finance was an issue. I don't know. Maybe they took your money, never gave you back, or they might have told you that you earn less than them, or you're not financially as stable. I don't know. So some of you, it could be that. For others of you, it just shows to me that this person left you out in the cold, and you know, they are one of those people who cannot support the other person. Like, they will only be in a relationship with you till things go well. But the moment shit goes down, they leave. They're the first one to leave. So I see that was the obstacle. And this person was being very manipulative. They were not revealing themselves. That's what the death card is. A lot of secrets. And as I already said, there might have been a lot of people involved here. Some of you, third party, for others of you, family. I don't know. And all you wanted was a stability and be all end all. Okay, what is the next move of Aquarius? What is Aquarius wanting next in their life? Two of Cups. Oh, Aquarius, you really wanted a love connection, like a solid thing. That's all you wanted, an equal partnership. You really, really had a lot of feelings for this person, and you just wanted a be all end all. Damn, you really were hoping for a stability with this person, like really, 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 really. All you wanted was happiness. You did not wanted money, you did not wanted anything. You just wanted happiness with this person. This person was your happiness, you know. But they disappointed you, like heavily. Okay. Six of Pentacles. Yeah, you just wanted an equal give and take. You wanted them to put in as much effort as you are putting and not bread from you. Okay. Future for Aquarius. World card. I see that you will be starting something new. That's what the World card is. New beginnings. And that beginning is actually going to lead to a completion, okay? So it's a very good card, basically. You're closing the chapter or closing the doors that do not serve you any longer, and you're moving on. Some of you feel that you want new beginning in life, you want stability in life, and if that requires leaving behind people and not paying attention to toxic people, if that what it takes, I'm gonna do it. So some of you being in a very determined energy, okay? Queen of Swords, see, you're just being very logical these days. Your head is ruling the heart, which is good. Three of Cups. you really wanted a partnership, like an equal give and take. That's what you wanted. You just wanted emotions from this person and they could not give you even that. You want some of you, this could be a friendship, because Three of Cups can be friendship. Like you wanted a friendship with somebody. For others of you, you wanted a connection with somebody, but this person was acting weird. They were bringing in drama. And then now you're like putting an end to the situation, being very logical and moving on. You're like, okay, I'm just going to go. I'm going to look for a new beginning, which is good. If that what it takes, I'm going to do it. What else? Four of Pentacles. And you know, the good thing, and Nine of Pentacles. Some of you, you're being very secretive about your money plans these days. So you're like up for something big. You might be investing somewhere, or you're doing something in your money situation. You're not telling people about it. Very silently, you're working towards your goals. And from Four of Pentacles, you're going to Nine of Pentacles. I see your money situation really improving. So a lot of abundance coming in. And when it comes to love, this person has hurt you and now you're working on a new partnership, or you're just looking for a new change. Again, you're just not expressing a lot to other people. You're keeping your things to yourself these days. You have become a very private person after this interaction with this person, Aquarius. Anything else? Five of Swords. Yeah, see? You're being very competent as well. Your life is going to change very drastically. I see things turning around. Wheel of Fortune represent fast moving changes. So your life that is going for a toss right now is going to also come up. So don't have to worry about it. With the Five of Swords energy, I see that you might also have to give a competition to somebody. Like you might have to face some sort of competition. But the good thing is that you're silently already preparing for everything and you're just going after things. And you're very confident in yourself. Okay, what else? Four of Cups. See, you're being very private about things these days, not telling to a lot of people, just being in your own energy. With the Wheel of Fortune, I also see that something which is meant for you is coming towards you. So like whatever obstacles you went through, that was to make you realize that you are trying to find happiness in a wrong place. And you have this Ace of Cups to Ten of Cups journey coming in for you that you have been trying to manifest. So that's coming in for you. You don't have to worry. So a relationship, a be-all, end-all, a commitment is coming in. And some of you, your money, like your money and love both is improving, you know. And this looks like a destiny thing. It's like it was part of your destiny. You just went through whatever you went through so that you realize that, you know, sometimes it is very important to know what you should not have in life than to know what you want in life. So you were going through a phase and universe was basically telling you that you don't want this in life. You don't want that in life. This does not work for you. That does not work for you. Learn your lesson, you know, that kind of thing. Okay, what next? Anything next? Anything else for my Aquarius coming? Nine of Swords. You are really headed towards a fast moving change. Like things are just moving in your life very quickly, or it will. You know, Knight of Swords is a very fast paced energy. And this could be you, like just going after things one after the other. Some of it could be travel as well, because Knight of Swords can mean travel. Yeah. Finally, life taking turns. Page of Swords. Somebody is also stalking you. Somebody you left behind is stalking you these days. Lovers. You will have a choice in love, some of you, you know. You definitely are going to have a choice in love. And that could be between an old person and a new person. For some of you, it could be two new person, I don't know. But you will have a choice. Take time and choose wisely, all right? And there is someone that you've left behind, like you're done. Now you're moving towards this new connection. Some of you, you really were hoping for this connection to work with somebody and they were not paying attention. And now you're moving towards this new love connection and this past person is talking to you. So it's like when you wanted, this person did not want you. When you don't want them now, they want you, you know. And that has been revealed to you in a very mysterious way with the Wheel of Fortune. So yeah, definitely I see something new coming in and you have manifested. It's going to be really, really fast. And I also see someone from the past might be knocking back at your door, but some of you, you've already made a decision that you don't want them. If you want them, you can have them, but if not, then... And I also see for some of you, see forgiving and learning, somebody wants to ask for forgiveness. I also see that the next connection that is coming towards you is also going to be very sexual. And you know, it's a very random message that wants to come in, but yeah, with the cards showing up here, I see that whoever is going to be your next person is also going to be someone who's very sexual. So yeah, they are going to be stable, like wedding, etc. is possible because we have 10 of cups. So it could be a be-all and all thing, but it's also going to be a very fun connection, you know. See, very soon, wasn't I telling you? All the while in the reading, very soon this is coming in. You just have to love yourself. And when you love yourself, you're vibrating high, you emit that energy and you will find the right person, okay? So don't have to worry. Attraction, forgiving and learning, healing, family issues. I see that somebody wants your forgiveness. And I see a lot of love coming in. A lot of attraction, as I said, it's going to be a sexual, passionate connection. And some healing is required. You're already healing yourself. Keep doing that. And you're good to go. It's a very beautiful, empowering reading, Aquarius. I'm really happy for you. I will see you next week. Till then, you guys take care. Stay safe. Bye.